This video is proudly brought to you by Hovatek. Hovatek. Just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be explaining how to manually install Spreadtrum USB drivers on your Windows PC. Now, before you begin this, we are going to be using the manual method, which means not the regular exe installation method which you are probably used to. We'll be using a manual method. Now, before you can manually install drivers on your Windows, you need to know whether or not the driver is digitally signed. Now, if it has a digital signature, Windows definitely allows you to install it. But if it is not signed, you are most likely going to get an error or not even be allowed to install such drivers. So that means you need to disable your signature verification. For Windows 7, you can install drivers without having to necessarily disable that setting. But for Windows 8, you are not allowed to install unsigned drivers. So what you can do is to disable signature check or signature verification to allow you to install the drivers. Now, for the guide on how to do that, you can check for it on one of the videos I've uploaded, or you can check our website for how to disable signature verification on Windows 8. You'd get the full guide and new video on how to do that. But I will not be doing that for this tutorial, to just keep things as brief as possible. So after disabling signature verification on your Windows 8, that's if you're using a Windows 8 as I'm using, you now want to get your drivers folder here. So what I'll do is extract the folder from the zip file. Alright, since that is done, I will cross check to show you there's no exe file here. As you can see, there's no exe file, so there's no way to use an installer here. No MSI, no exe. So that means I'm going to have to use the manual method, as I earlier said. So to install manually, you have to open Device Manager. So I'll just come to the search bar, search for Device Manager. Okay, I launch my Device Manager. I'll just drag this down here so you can see it. All right, so what you want to do next is just highlight any item. I just highlighted the first item. Then click the Action tab, Add Legacy Hardware. Now you get a wizard, just click next. Now I will not be searching online for the hardware, sorry, for the driver. I already have that on my PC. So I'll just tick the second option, which is to select the driver manually from my PC. That is the advanced option, and then next. Here you just click next. Now I'm going to load the .inf file manually for my PC, so just click have disk. At this point, I'm going to load the .inf file. Now I'll go back to the Hovatek folder so you see what I'm doing here. So this is the Spreadtrum drivers folder I extracted earlier on, so I'll just open it. You go to the SCI U2S folder. Now, depending on your PC's architecture, you select this if it's 32 bits and this is a 64 bit. I'm using a 64-bit Windows 8 PC, so I'll just go with the 64-bit folder. I open the driver folder, and here is my driver, the SCI-U2S. If you look down here, you can see it's a .inf file. But that's the driver I'm trying to install. So I highlight it and then open. And I click OK. Now you can see the warning I mentioned earlier. This driver is not digitally signed, which means normally if you didn't disable that setting, you would not be allowed to go beyond this point. But since I earlier disabled the signature verification settings for my Windows 8, I'll be able to proceed with the installation. So I just click next, and then I click next to begin the installation. All right, so my drivers are installed. Now most people tend to have a question about this particular point of the installation. So this device cannot start, error code 10. Now when you get an error code 10 on a Windows PC, it basically tells you that the driver might not work. not necessarily that driver will not work, it might not work. Now, is that a driver you've tried to, is that driver you've installed is not compatible with your PC, or it is not signed? Now, in this case, the driver is not signed. And for that reason, Windows tends to believe that an unsigned driver is probably not safe or not good for you. You understand? So that's why I'm getting the error code 10. So you might still be able to use the driver normally on your PC and everything will work just fine, even with this code 10. But if you still have the code 10 and if you have the code 10 and your drivers still are not working, then I need to consider some other steps, which is beyond the scope of this tutorial. But just thinking that this code 10, when installing an unsigned driver, doesn't necessarily mean the driver will not work. It's just because the driver is unsigned that you are getting this code 10. So just proceed with your flashing or whatever I want to do with the drivers. Do not panic. So at this point, I'm done. I click finish. Now, I also want to install the Google USB driver. So, sorry, I come here, add legacy hardware. That's the same very procedure we went through the first time. Click next, have disk. This time around, I'll be loading my drivers from the Google USB folder. Sorry, from the Google USB folder. Okay, Google USB driver. Okay, so I just select Android Windows USB. Here it is here, and open. Okay, when I'm done, same thing, is not digitally signed. As I earlier mentioned, you need to disable signature verification if you want to go beyond this point. I click next to install the same code 10, but it doesn't mean my driver will not work fine. It's just because it's unsigned I'm having this error. So finish. So basically, that is just how to install your Spreadtrum driver on Windows PC. So if I scroll down here, I see my Spreadtrum here detected. Here they are. So that's basically how it's done.